in the B, just we have the remaining 2 milliseconds. So V 35. B is complete. We can take 4 from the C, and the C also will be complete. D already complete in second. So again we will go for the round 4. Only there is one process of the 3 millisecond and D and 42. Now we will calculate the average waiting time. So we will calculate the average waiting time. So we will calculate the waiting time of all the algorithms. A, waiting time of B, waiting time of C, and waiting time of D. From start to end, for considering A start from 0 and we are completing the A on 33 minus 0. Or what is the execution time of A? Is 15 minus 15. Again, we are taking the B, for the B, the we are completing B on 35 minus from where we are taking the B from the 0 minus 10. Again for the C, for C the total time is C kahan complete hua aapka 39 pe. 39 minus 0 minus 2 time, waiting time of D. Waiting time of D 42 minus 0 minus 5. So we will calculate the average of all the times. So that will be 33 minus 15. 18, 35 minus 10, 25, 39 minus 12, 27, 42 minus 5, 37. So that will be the, we can go average of all. Average waiting time equals to 18 plus 25 plus 27 plus 37 divided by number 4. So just take the sum of that. One zero seven divided by the number of 4. So that is all CPU scheduling algorithm. In the next lecture we will discuss another topic. Okay.